All right. Okay, let's have a look at the intro. So, pretty simple. We're going to be working with the G chord that we saw, and then the C D chord. And the intro is basically, remember, pluck, pluck, down, up, up, down, up, down, pluck, down to the C D chord, pluck, pluck, down, up, up, down, up, down, back up to the C G chord, the G chord, pluck, pluck, down, up, up, down, up, down, back down to the C D chord, pluck, pluck, down, up, up, down, up, down, and that leads into, okay, so you do that twice. So you start with the G, C, D, back up to the G, back down to the C, D. That's your intro. As you're moving back up the third time to the G chord, that's where we start singing the first verse. So let's have a look at that. All right, let's have a look at the first verse. For every rose has its thorn, poison. So as I said in the previous clip, you've just done your intro, so you've gone from G to C, D, back to G. You've done that twice. As you're coming back up, you pluck twice, and then you start singing. So,
we both lie sadly still in the dead of the night.
Notice I'm doing the cymbal strum. Okay, I can also do it.
We both lie close together.
So I can also do it like the original.
We both lie close together, miles apart.
You see? Ah, it's usually a pop on.
We both lie silent still in the middle of the night. Although we both lie close together,
okay, so notice, like the intro, we did it twice. Okay, now we're going to do the same, but notice that the beat changes. We switch a little more quickly between the chords. Okay, so.
We both lie silently still in the dead of the night. Although we both lie close together, we feel miles apart inside.
Back up to the G.
Was it something I said down to the C? Something I did my words not come out right.
So twice G C D, right? G C D G C D, but a little more quickly as you saw there. And then we go down to D.
Though I tried not to hurt you,
and then C.
Though I tried, but I guess that's why they say.
Okay, and that's the verse. So, quick recap, we start with a G, pluck twice, we do this pattern down to the C. So we do that twice. Keep in mind the last part of this lesson, we're going to put everything together. I'm actually going to sing the whole song from beginning to end. So that'll always be a guide for you as you progress. All right? So let's have a look at the chorus.
Okay, chorus. So as we saw there, we were finishing up
right in the verse. And from that C chord, we simply go back up here to the
every rose, G has its thorn.
Down to the C, D, back up to the G.
Every rose has its thorn.
Okay, now here we go back up to the G.
Every D,
down to D.
Cowboy sings a sad,
the C, D,
sad song. Its thorn.
C, D. try that again. So.
Every rose G has its thorn.
C, D. Notice the strum pattern is the same.
Every night has its dawn. Every cowboy D sings a sad C sad song. And then G, every rose has its thorn. Down to C, D.
And there you have it for chorus. Let's have a look at the bridge. Okay, let's have a look at the bridge for Every Rose. So once we've played, we've done the intro, we've done a verse, then a chorus, then another verse, then another chorus. And after that second chorus, then we move into what we call a bridge, which is a slightly different, that's where the E minor chord comes in. So basically, you would play your E minor.
Though it's been,
well, let's finish up with the actual chorus, right? So,
rose has its thorn.
That's the second time we play the chorus. And then we go into,
though it's been
E minor,
though it's been a while now,
D,
I can still
see,
feel so much pain,
G. And then here you basically pluck the top string on the third fret and then the second fret. And then you go back to your E minor. So it sounds something like this. Okay? So it would go something like this.
Though it's been a while now.
Okay, so E minor.
Though it's been a while now.
D.
I can still feel C. So much pain.
G. Back to E minor. And then we go back to our G
main.
And then we finish up with the last verse, and you'll see I'm going to be playing this at the end in the full, playing the full song. All right? So there you have it. Right? Let's have a look at vocals. Great. So now we've got the chords, we've got the strumming patterns, we've got the song structure, and we're ready to go, right? So again, keep in mind that if you're just getting started, strumming and playing is not always that easy. So what do you need to do? Keeping in mind, you don't need to be a virtuoso on guitar. If you just do the simple up and down pattern to get started, your brain's going to start putting all of this together, okay? So not to worry, and as you progress, then you can start adding a few little extras. But again, the patterns I'm showing you are the standard patterns for the strumming on the down, up, up, down, up, down. But you can play, remember? So,
every rose has its thorn.
Nothing wrong with that.
It's like every night has its dawn.
So keep in mind, that's very important, because a lot of times people say, I can't play and sing at the same time. But that's because they're trying to change the world with their guitar playing. So necessarily, their brain is so filled up with information that they can't put it together. Okay? So, some tips and tricks. You saw that, depending on your range, if you've got more of a low range, you should be able to sing this. It's not extremely high, but one suggestion, take your capo, put it on the 6th fret. 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay? Now you'll see, everything you learned in the previous section applies. Okay? But just imagine that now with the capo, you're not going to be playing up here, right? You're going to be playing where you would play from the 2nd fret. So everything applies, right? So then I would play. Just for you to get a feel, right?
Although we both lie close together, a few miles apart,
so that, for those of you who think that the original was a little too high-pitched, just try practicing this way, okay? The guitar, the tone of the guitar sounds a little, the pitch is a little higher, but it actually gives a good sound. There are a lot of songs with capos up here, like the James Blunt songs, for example. So give that a try if the original pitch is too high. But keep in mind that the chords are identical, so we haven't changed. That's why the capo is a magical tool for your vocals, especially as it gets started. Now, if that's too low for you, then try putting the capo maybe on this third. Again, you can try on all the frets, okay? But this is just a quick suggestion so you can grasp it quickly. So watch. So here it's if you wanted to go up higher, right? So.
We both lie silently still in the dead of the night. Although we both lie close together, we feel miles apart inside.
So you see, for the girls out there, you probably, some of you have extremely high-pitched voices, so even playing the original, maybe your voice has a much higher range, so by adjusting the capo, you're going to be able to find that exact tone. Again, forget about the original if the original doesn't fit. We told you we would find your voice. This is a good start to finding your voice, all right? I'm going to put everything together now in the last section, okay? So that's the My Guitar, My Voice section. So what I recommend, let's have a look at that. But what I recommend in that section is really that you focus initially on the guitar only, then on the vocals, and you'll see that your brain is going to start putting everything together and you'll be able to sing and play at the same time, all right? So thanks for this, and let's go on to the next section.